हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर कपिल चतुर्वेदी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, सागर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ रिसर्च टेक्नोलॉजी एंड साइंस। टुडे विल डिस्कस द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंटरफेस इन जावा। इन द अर्लियर क्लासेस वी डिस्कस द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एज वेल द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट क्लास। In case of inheritance, we discussed the inheritance is a process of acquiring the features of base classes, and the concept of inheritance have some types like single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance. But in case of Java, Java does not support multiple inheritance due to its complexity. Then we discuss the concept of abstract class, in which we discuss if a class contain at least one abstract method, then that class is known as abstract class. And the abstract method will be the method which has no body. So we discuss in detail to implement and framework or to implement a template to implement a program, we propose we use the concept of abstract class. So definition of abstract class says that if a class contain at least one abstract method, then that class is known as abstract class. And what is abstract method? An abstract method is a method which has no body. So basically, abstract class is a combination of abstract and non-abstract method. And then we see an scenario in which we calculate the salary of employees, manager, programmer, and clerk. And also we see an example in which we create an abstract class in which where we contain both type of class methods, abstract method and non-abstract method. Abstract methods are TA, DA and TTS, and the non-abstract method is bonus. I told you that a method has no body is known as abstract method. So there is a method TA with no body, DA has also no body, TS is also has no body. So this method is known as abstract method. And if a method has some definitions, then that method is known as non-abstract method. So this class contains some abstract method and some non-abstract method. So if we put this combination inside of any class, then that class is known as abstract class. Okay, I'm repeating, abstract class is a class having at least one abstract method. We extend that scenario of putting at least one abstract method in a class. Instead of this definition, if I say you that I am putting all the method as abstract method, if a class contain all the method as abstract method, then that class will not be abstract class. If a class contain all the method as abstract method, then that class will not be known as abstract class. That class will be known as interface. So the definition of interface is that a pure interface is a pure abstract class. It means interface will contain all the methods as abstract. Or we can say that methods which will be inside of an interface will never have body. So we cannot put non-abstract method in interface. The formal definition of interface is that an interface is a reference type. An interface is a reference type in Java. It is similar to class. It is a collection of abstract methods. So basically we are saying that The interface is a collection of abstract methods. A class implements an interface, thereby inheriting the abstract methods of the interface along with abstract methods. An interface may also contain constants, default methods, static methods, and nested types. So we will discuss this theory in the example of interface. By taking an example of interface, we'll implement this. And here we are taking the same example. To implement interface, we have to calculate the salary of employees, manager, programmer, clerk. We have three types of employees: manager, programmer, and clerk. And we have to calculate TA, DA, HRA of these employees, and then we have to calculate the total salary of the employees. So in this case, we are saying that we have to implement only abstract methods. We cannot create non-abstract method. It means we will not implement the bonus method inside of that class. So let me go on the example of that interface. So I am using Crimson editor. To write the program and implement the program. Here we are using the Crimson editor to write our program. So here we are creating an interface, INF, and inside of that I am creating only one abstract method at with its prototype, and I am implementing another interface INF1, and I am putting one abstract method inside of that interface, that MUL. So we are not giving any definition of add and MUL because we have to make this method as abstract method. As we discussed, the definition of interface is that interface will never have any non-abstract method. Or we say that interface will always have the abstract methods, abstract method which have no body. So we are putting abstract method add in interface 1 INF, and INF 1 we put the method MUL. INF 2 we are implementing another interface INF 2 which extends INF 1. So we are basically inherit INF 2 with INF 1, and here we are putting one method SUB with prototype int A and int B. And then I create a simple class my class, and I implement INF1, implements INF2 and INF. One thing is very important in this scenario: implements INF1 and INF, it means I am indirectly or directly inherit the interface 1 in INF and INF 2 INF and INF 2. It means I am indirectly inherit INF 1, because INF 2 already inherit INF 1. It means INF 2 already have the features of INF 1. INF2s can access MUL directly because it has inherited by INF1. So indirectly we can say that my class is implementing by INF1, INF2 and INF also. So whenever we inherit interfaces in a simple class, we use term implements instead of extends. When we inherit a simple class, in another simple class, we use the term extends. What whenever we inherit an interface in a simple class, we use term implements. So once we implement the interfaces in a simple class, this is the mandatory thing. We have to overwrite all the methods, all the abstract methods which we implement. It means that is the mandatory thing to overwrite at MUL and SUB in my class, because we are implementing these interfaces. Now we overwrite add by providing appropriate functioning MUL and respectively SUB. So SUB, MUL and add are the methods of INF2, INF1 and INF. So we overwrite these all methods in our simple class, my class, and we create the object of my class OBJ and call the respective methods. The program is very simple. What the logic is that? First logic is that we are implementing an interface, and interface will always have only abstract methods. And the second concept says to you that when one interface inherit another interface, we use term extends. And when we inherit interfaces in a simple class, we use term implements. And one more important point is that we can implement or we can inherit more than one interfaces in a simple class. As you know very well that Java does not support multiple inheritance. It means we cannot extend multiple base classes in a single class, in a single drive class. But here that rule conflict, in case of interface, we can implement more than one interfaces in a simple class. We cannot extend, but we can implement more than one interfaces in a single class, simple class. So 3 point is important. First is the definition of interface, which says that interface is a collection of abstract methods, or we can say that interface is a pure abstract class. Second point is that interface can extend another interface by using extends keyword, but a simple class can inherit interfaces by using keyword implements. And third point is a simple class can inherit or implements more than one interfaces, and then we overwrite this method and invoke the object and perform the functioning. So this is the concept of interface, which is also used to implement a template for implementing like applications like payroll implementation. So this is the concept of interface. So to understand these topics, you will have to first focus on inheritance, then abstract class, then interface, so that you can remember these all things very easily in your mind. So this is the concept of interface.